Hi everyone, welcome to this video on getting started with the document editor component by Syncfusion in a Blazor server application. In this video, I will explain how to create a Blazor application and add the Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor package. Then I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor document editor component to the Blazor server application. After creating the document editor, I will show you how to open a document and then work with few of its prominent features, character formatting, paragraph formatting, adding a table of contents, and finally saving a document along with toolbar customization. To explore the features available in Syncfusion Document Editor component, you can visit our website link provided in the above YouTube card. I will create the Blazor project first. I can create a Blazor application either using Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I will create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. I have installed .NET Core SDK 3.1.2. To follow along with this video, you should have a basic understanding of C#, HTML, and CSS. Also, you can watch a detailed video on the basics of Blazor and Syncfusion controls with the title Create a Blazor Server App and Add Syncfusion Blazor Components, which I have shared in the YouTube card. Using Visual Studio 2019, I create a new project. I select the template Blazor app, provide the project name My Blazor Server App, and click Create. Here, the Blazor Server app was selected by default, so I proceed by clicking Create. Now, Visual Studio has generated a Blazor Server application. To use the Syncfusion Blazor Document Editor component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor NuGet package into my application. To do so, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project file and selecting Manage NuGet Packages. Under the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor package. I select it and click Install. The installation has been completed now. You can check it under the Dependencies folder. And within the Packages folder, you can see the Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor package added to this application. Next, I must register Syncfusion Blazor services to the services container. For that, I open the startup.cs file and use the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Within the configure services method, I make a call to the addSyncfusionBlazor method. This makes Syncfusion Blazor services available within the application. For this application, I need to increase the connection buffer size so that I can upload Word documents larger than 32 KB from client to server. As you know, the Blazor application uses a signal or connection to manage communication between the server and client. By default, signal or limits the buffer size to 32 KB. So, to increase the connection buffer size, I use the maximum receive message size property to increase the buffer size. Next, I must register a valid Syncfusion license key. To do so, in the configure method, I call the Syncfusion license provider class static method registerLicense. You need to pass your Syncfusion license key as a string parameter in the registerLicense method. I have done it off screen. Within the pages folder, open the host.cshtml file. Within the head tag, add the required CSS file to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. In this example, I refer the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor package. Now, let me add the Syncfusion Blazor document editor component to the index component. To do so, I use the Syncfusion Blazor document editor namespace. Adding this namespace here will allow me to use the document editor component markup in this index component page. Also, I can import this namespace in the imports.razor page to make it available in all components within this application. I remove the existing code, type the SF document editor container tag, and set the height and width to it. Let me save the file and run the application. You can see the document editor component. I click the open button and choose a document to open it from this local machine. You can see the document is loaded in the document editor component. By default, the toolbar is enabled in the document editor. I can also load a document file at the initial load of the document editor control using the created event. Let me show you how to achieve this through code. Before accessing the created event, I need to access the document editor as object in C#. I need to add a reference name to the document editor container. To do so, I add the ref attribute and assign the value container. Within the code directive, I add a variable of type sf-document-editor-container named container. Now, within the document editor container tag, I add the document editor container events tag and the created event and assign the method name onCreated. Within the code, I implement this method private void onCreated. I create a variable of type string name document path and assign the document file path. I add code to read the document using file stream and load them to a Word document object. I serialize the document to a JSON object, which is in the SFDT format and passed as a parameter to the open method. Finally, I have disposed of the document object. I use the Newtonsoft JSON namespace. Let me save the file and run the application. You can see the document is loaded in the document editor at the initial load. In the loaded document, you can format the characters. I select the text ASP.NET Core and click the bold and italic icons. You can see the formatted characters. Also, I can change the style of the paragraph. Let me add the text, table of contents, click the font color button and select a color. I set the font size to 16. Then I click the table of contents button to automatically add a table of contents to the document. I can choose the header levels to be added in my table of contents. I can also choose whether to show the page numbers, right align those page numbers, and use hyperlinks to navigate them to the respective pages. I click the button and you can see the table of contents in the document. Now, let me show you how to save the document after editing. To save the document, first I need to convert the document to a byte array and then save it as a file. Let me show you how to save the document when I click on the Save Toolbar button. First, I will add a custom toolbar item, Save button. In the SF Document Editor container tag, I add the property Toolbar Items and set a value Items. Within the code directive, I implement this items property. To add the save button next to the new toolbar button, I add the new custom toolbar item model with the ID save to identify the toolbar item uniquely, text as save, and set the prefix icon as save icon, the class to get the save icon. Using the style tag, I add the class save icon with the before sudo element so that the save icon will be added before the display text save. Here I add the content property with the save icon value which is shipped along with the Syncfusion Blazor WordProcessor package. Now I save the file and run the application. You can see the save toolbar item added next to the new button. Now let me add code to save the document once I click on this save toolbar item. To catch the click event when the toolbar item is clicked, I need to hook the click event of the toolbar. So, within the document editor container events tag, I add the onToolbarClickEvent and assign the method name onItemClick. Within the code directive, I add the void method onItemClick with a parameter of type ClickEventAux. To access the ClickEventAux class, I use the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Navigations. Within the onItemClick, I add a switch statement and provide the value as aux.item.id. I add the case for save. The ID I have already provided for the save toolbar item. I add the break statement to end the flow. Now within the save case, I create an object of type document editor module named editor and assign the containers getDocumentEditor method call to get the instance of the editor. I add Code to call the editors save as blob method by passing the format type as docx so that the file will be saved in docx format. Then I deserialize the base64 data using JSON convert class and then save it as a byte array. Next, I will create a new memory stream using this data stored as a byte array. Finally, I write this newly created stream to the path of the document again using the FileStream object. Let me move the document path variable to the outer scope so that I can access it in onItemClick method also. Now, I save the file and run the application. In the text document, I add the table of contents and then I click the save button. Let me refresh the browser to open the saved file. You can see the document is shown with the table of contents that we added. In my next video, I will show you how to open and save a Word document from Azure Cloud File Storage using Syncfusion Blazor Document Editor component. The video link is provided in the description of this video. If you need more information about the Syncfusion Blazor Document Editor component, you can refer to our online documentation. The documentation link is provided in the description of this video. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.